cancer is on the increase worldwide, with up to 12 million cases diagnosed annually. One of the most important oncogenes in cancer is a gene called RAS, which is mutant in 20 to 25% of all cancers. Until now, RAS has been extremely difficult to target, so we don't have good drugs that will target mutant RAS cancers. Recently, it's become clear that mutant RAS activates a process called autophagy, which leads to a digestion of intracellular components through these autophagic vesicles. And so we became interested in knowing whether or not we could target these RAS-driven autophagy pathway and possibly find small molecules that might regulate it. And what we discovered in my lab was that increased autophagy is accompanied by alterations in the activity of a specific kinase called casein kinase 1, and that this may represent a point of vulnerability for these cancers.
We validated this finding using complementary genetic and chemical approaches. Removal or inhibition of casein kinase 1 alpha indeed increases autophagic vesicles in these mutant RAS-driven cancer cells. Gene expression arrays show that the removal of casein kinase 1 alpha increases the expression of a number of core autophagy genes in mutant RAS-driven cancers of diverse tissue origins. Importantly, about 50% of these commonly upregulated genes have been shown to be controlled by the fork hitbox transcription factor FOXO3A. Turns out that mutant RAS makes lots of casein kinase 1 alpha proteins. In turn, casein kinase 1 alpha modifies FOXO3A and reduces its nuclear abundance to prevent hyperactivation of autophagic processes in the mutant RAS-driven cancer cells. We speculate that this casein kinase 1 alpha FOXO3A signaling pathway may be critical to the survival of mutant RAS-driven cancer cells. We therefore tested whether the growth of these mutant RAS-driven cancer cells can be stopped by the casein kinase 1 alpha inhibitor D4476 alone or in combination with the anti-malaria drug chloroquine. Chloroquine is also known to block autophagic intracellular digestion and is currently being assessed in many clinical trials as a new anti-cancer drug. While casein kinase 1 alpha blockade by D4476 only modestly stopped growth of mutant RAS cancer cells, we found that the combination of D4476 and chloroquine is particularly effective in stopping the growth of mutant RAS-driven cancer cells. Using a mouse model of cancer xenograft development, we showed that the combination of D4476 and chloroquine is indeed effective in stopping the growth of mutant RAS-driven human colon and bladder cancers. Electron microscopic image of tumors treated with the combination of D4476 and chloroquine confirmed the buildup of autophagic vesicles in these mutant RAS-driven cancer cells, as well as an increase in cancer cell death. Our findings provide the mechanistic basis of exploring combination therapies involving pharmacological targeting of casein kinase 1 alpha and autophagic intracellular digestion to fight specific types of human cancers, especially those driven by mutant RAS.
So this is an exciting lead. If we can identify specific molecules that target these RAS-driven cancers and have high-potency selective inhibitors of casein kinase 1 that can pair with autophagy inhibitors, we hope to have an impact on cancer. So first we need rigorous preclinical studies, and then we move on, if we have the right drug combinations, to clinical studies, and finally have an effective therapy for these RAS-driven cancers.